This semester we will be programming in a language called Snap, and today's voiceover is going to get you started on how to actually run Snap in your browser and have you get started on making your first program. So this should run in any web browser that runs JavaScript, although I do want to show you that it has had a couple of errors, just so that you know that you've got the right browser working. So if you bring it up in Chrome, it should look a lot like this. You bring up snap.berkeley.edu, and it'll bring up a web page that looks like this, and then scroll down and click on the big Run Snap Now button. And you should get a screen that looks a lot like this. What could happen, now keep in mind I'm going to do all my voiceovers on a Mac this semester. It should work just fine on Windows as well. But if you do see an error that looks like this, I want you to be aware that you need to switch browsers. So I bring it up and it looks like it's working fine. And I click on Run Snap Now and it gives me a blank screen. If you get that, switch browsers. It has worked in Firefox for me, but the most reliable browser so far has been Chrome. If you get any errors other than the blank screen or even the blank screen and you can't get it fixed, try using Chrome, which is a free browser that's available for all the OSs. And if that doesn't work, post to the discussion board for help. Now we're going to switch back over to the full screen view so that you can see how everything is working. So when you got Snap started, you're going to have 8 little buttons up here in the upper left-hand corner. There's one labeled Motion, Look, Sound, Pen, Control, Sensing, Operators, and Variables. And we're going to focus today, just for the quick intro to make sure that Snap is actually running for you, on the motion thing. This big gray area in the middle is where you write your programs, and we'll get to that in just a second. And then the white area over on the right is where you can actually make this little thing. It's called a sprite, and you can make it move around the screen. And you can make that bigger if you want. And click on this arrow key here, and that'll make it full screen. So that we can actually see our programs, we're going to leave it in the small mode. So you might notice that there's sort of little snapping motions to these blocks. See, I can drag this block over here, and it says move 10 steps. And what that means is it's going to move this little sprite thing over 10 steps. Now, where the name came from, I'm going to switch really quickly to the control panel. We'll talk about controls in a whole lot more depth, but for right now, you need some way to just start your program. And so I'm going to drag this little when flag clicked icon. And you notice that it like snapped together with the other block. That's where the name came from. So now I can make my first program. When I click the flag, the little sprite will move. See, every time I click the flag, the little sprite goes somewhere. Not too exciting, but at least you know now how to make your program work. Some other fun beginning things, in addition to making it move around, I'd encourage you to just play around in the motion thing here to just see what happens. So I'm going to, for example, have it move 10 steps and then turn 15 degrees. And then move 10 steps and turn 15 degrees every time I click the flag. That's going to make my sprite turn as it goes around the screen. Okay. There are lots of other interesting buttons that one can play with in here. And since this is just an introduction here, we're going to look at, we've been focusing on the scripts tab here. Let's move over to the costumes tab. And in the costumes tab, you can actually change what your little sprite looks like. So if you click on the little button here that says paint a new costume, you can draw a picture. I will draw something that approximates a smiley face. Well, I didn't really want it up there. Let's try that again. There we go. When you draw your picture, it's really important to know where the center of your picture is, and it guesses that it's over there, but since I didn't draw my circle in the center, I'm actually just going to move the center to the center of the circle. Okay? And now, my sprite, it's giant, but it shows up as a smiley face. So if I wanted to do that, I can. I encourage you to go around and play with those. You can also import pictures from the net if you just want to have like a specific picture bounce around the screen. So for right now, the other part of the introduction script, we're going to get to the lots more fun stuff and actually making games and other fun programs and all the other voiceovers. But for this, we wanted to make sure that you can start Snap, that you can write a program, and that you can save it. And so that's the next thing that we're going to talk about. If you go up here to the menus, it says Snap, and then there's a little picture of a piece of paper with a corner folded over. That's the menu where you can actually save. And we're going to say, now you're being tempted to go in here and you're going to click Save. And you could do that, and it will work, but it won't work in a way that you can actually submit it in for grading. So what save does is it will enable you to save. You can either save it in your browser, or you can save it in the cloud. And I highly suggest that you create a cloud account So let's click here and just show you where to do that. Click on the little cloud icon. And you, if you're not logged in, I was already logged in, you can click on sign up and you can create yourself an account. And when you do that and bring up the save and go to the cloud, you can see all the other things you've saved. And that's useful so that you can work on any computer and you can load your programs on any computer. So when you go to the file menu, what you're gonna do is you're gonna go in and instead of saving, and saving's fine, saving will give it to the cloud, but you won't be able to turn it in for grading. Go to the export project and it'll bring up a little menu and it wants to know what you wanna name it. I'm gonna name it test save. Say okay. And it brings up a window that looks like this. This looks sort of awful if you don't have any idea what it is. Don't worry about what it is. All you need to do now is actually just save this. So go into Chrome and say save page as and save it somewhere. I'm gonna save mine to my desktop. Okay, so that file saves and that's the file you're gonna turn in when you turn in anything for grading. Let's go back over here. Let's create a new one so that our thing is gone. And then let's show you how to load it back in. So you go to the same menu and then you click on import. And remember I said I saved it to my desktop and I'm just going to click on test save and there it is. So this was just a quick introduction to make sure that Snap actually runs in your browser. If you have any troubles or you just get stuck in any way, make sure you post to the discussion forum because in order to actually complete the rest of the semester, you need to be able to have Snap run.